And before we go, a watch that was once owned by the last emperor of China's Qing dynasty sells for a record $6.2 million at a Hong Kong auction. An Asian collector bought the rare Patek Philippe watch that had belonged to Isinghyoro Puyi, whose life formed the basis of the Oscar-winning film The Last Emperor. It was one of only eight known reference 96 Kuantan Loon timepieces and was gifted by Puyi to his Russian interpreter when he was imprisoned in the Soviet Union. The Phillips Asia Auction House says it's the highest result for any wristwatch that once belonged to an emperor and easily beat the pre-sale estimate of $3 million. Former British Prime Minister Boris Johnson has been referred to authorities for new claims that he violated COVID-19 lockdown rules. The information came to light as the Cabinet Office prepared submissions for a public inquiry into the pandemic. Government-funded lawyers found entries in Johnson's ministerial diary detailing potential breaches at Chequers, the official countryside home of the sitting prime minister. Regional police office noted the visits were dated between June 2020 and May 2021. His team called the referral a politically motivated attempt to manufacture something out of nothing. Johnson was previously fined for holding parties and gatherings during the height of the pandemic. The political scandal contributed to his resignation in 2022. Four Navy officers charged with murdering a homeless and disabled man in Chile now in detention. Monday's court order came after the release of dramatic CCTV footage that showed six people, allegedly including the Marines, standing around the victim. The video shows one of the assailants hitting the victim on the head with a crutch. The homeless man died shortly afterwards due to a traumatic brain injury. A female student is suspected of starting the deadly fire at a school dormitory in Guyana that killed 19 children. Police say the student lit the fire after school authorities confiscated her phone. The victims, mostly indigenous girls, died around midnight Monday, most at the scene. Police have not mentioned an arrest, and the mayor of the town where the school is located could not confirm whether the suspect is in custody. The country's president has declared 3 days of national mourning. Ukraine is investigating Belarus's suspected involvement in the forced transfer of children from Russian-occupied territory. That's after a preliminary report revealed more than 2,000 Ukrainian children were deported to so-called recreation camps and sanatoriums in Belarus. The report noted that transfers of minors, including orphans aged 6 to 15, were in violation of the Geneva Conventions and the Rome Statute. In March, the International Criminal Court issued arrest warrants for Russian President Vladimir Putin and Moscow's Ombudsman for Children's Rights for war crimes involving the illegal deportation of Ukrainian children. Kyiv has alleged that around 20,000 children from Ukraine have been forcibly transported or deported to Russia since the start of the war. Russia says it extinguished scores of what it called Ukrainian nationalists. Its military reported Tuesday at least 70 Ukraine-aligned fighters were killed in its operation to repel the cross-border raiders who entered the country's Belgorod region. It adds it is now pushing the remainder back into Ukraine. The governor of Belgorod also said a civilian was killed at the hands of Ukrainian armed forces. The two anti-Kremlin groups, which claim responsibility for the attack, both asserted they are comprised of armed Russian fighters seeking to overthrow Russian President Vladimir Putin. Moscow blames Kyiv, which has denied any involvement in the raid.